This is the Robotics Capstone, and this year students developed assistive robots that can help people with disabilities.
For a lot of students, this was their first time using a robot, and what they learned is that robots are very imprecise. And every group had their own problem that they were trying to tackle and had to deal with a different level of impreciseness.
The name of our project, we're calling it Team Big Stretch. And so essentially the point of our project is allow people who are like sort of mobility impaired, so whether they like are just out of surgery or they have some other mobility impairment, to be able to use our stretch robot.
My grandmother has mobility issues. We asked her what she could use a robot for, and one of the things she said was that she had trouble getting to her medicine. Having a robot do that for her would make things easier.
They can like specify the type of medicine that they want with just a couple easy buttons, and then the robot should be able to pick up the medicine and bring it to the user.
We got generally good feedback from our target user, and that all she has to do is click on the item to transmit her order to the robot. She added that the robot is cute.
I really like that. It's very self-driven by the students. We sort of decide to schedule on our own. We coordinate with each other to see what works best for everybody.
I honestly recommend that people take this Capstone.
Our project is Colostomy Care, where we utilize the Stretch 2 robot to navigate to the user to help the user to remove the colostomy bag such that the patient doesn't have to remove the bag themselves.
Right now we're finalizing our script for our presentation, and we're also adding some additional features like perception to our robot to supplement our navigation.
One of the problems that we encountered is the bag itself doesn't have a large area for the gripper. So in the future, we might be implementing bags that have like a larger surface area.
Best part of this course is that working in a team so that you have full control of your project. You can use any of the technology which you want.
Our project is developing a robotic aid to move people's limbs so they don't develop pressure sores because of mobility impairments.
It's generally recommended that repositioning is done every 2 hours.
With our solution, people with severe motor impairments can get the help they need and gain more independence in life.
Using the stretch robot and the devices that the UW Robotics team helped create, I am now able to independently move my arms up and down for a pressure relief whenever I need to. Thank you.
Okay, questions.
Where did the idea of the shop come from?
When we showed our demonstration of this to our user, he suggested we go for something more aesthetically appealing and easier to use. So that's why we decided on a strap in the end.
Our project name is Lending Hand. So our project is trying to do is get a stretch to retrieve the worker for people who are suffering from the Parkinson's disease.
A lot of this is first few weeks really getting up and going, having to have that mindset of like, okay, I'm just here to learn the code base as fast as possible, learn all the tools as fast as possible, and then be prepared for kind of a sprint to the finish.
Basically, everything is autonomous. We just have to click a button and then the robot would do everything. Initially, the first step is it has to navigate to the walker. So that's using stretch navigation. But yeah, after that, like everything is just using like the code we wrote.
I guess for me, I think it's pretty cool just to work with like the real robot, and also I was able to learn more like how you can program like software and robotics.
This is like a really expensive robot, so it's not something that you like have access to outside of like an academic setting. So getting a chance to get the robot to work in real life, not in simulation, pretty good experience.